trouble there in paradise with Lay Cool. Hopefully they'll get it back together, because I really think Lay Cool is a hell of a Divas tag team.
Well, it's been a tough week for Lay Cool, but it's been a tremendous week for those inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. Let's take you back to the highest-rated Hall of Fame induction ceremony in history.
Welcome, everyone, to the 2011 WWE Hall of Fame. It's a night when superstars and divas and legends and the WWE Universe all come together to honor the illustrious men and women who have carved their names into the annals of sports entertainment.
I can't tell you folks how proud I am to be up here.
And as long as there's air in Hacksaw Jim Duggan's lungs, I'll carry that flag of the United States of America.
For 7 years, I got to live my dream. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
The one and only Abdullah the Butcher!
Here I am back in the WWE at the Hall of Fame, and I could not be more honored. Like I've always said, what Sonny wants, Sonny gets.
They were, in my notion, the greatest tag team in the history of this business.
The Mighty Road Warriors.
What a rush!
That's for you, brother. The newest inductee into the celebrity wing of the WWE Hall of Fame, ladies and gentlemen, Drew Carey.
I'm so excited about my experience here. I'm thinking of changing my name back to Dwayne Johnson. It's seriously, I really had the best time, and I'm very, very humbled for being a small part of the WWE and the celebrity wing of the Hall of Fame. Thank you very much.
You are the showstopper, the icon, the main event, Mr. WrestleMania. But I've got another nickname for you, and that is Mr. Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, my best friend, the one and the only, Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
There are no words to express to each and every one of you how much I lived and breathed to do this every night of the week for so many years. I spent a lot of my life wanting all of you to think I did a good job. And I have to tell you, on this night, I want to thank you so much for giving me that. I am very thankful that I can stand here before you today and say that I am going into the Hall of Fame with absolutely no regrets. You all believed in me and thought I was good. And on this night, I thank you, and I love each and every one of you.
The following is a number one contenders match. Let me first introduce Alberto Del Rio's personal ring announcer, Ricardo Rodriguez.
Oh, Chibble never disappoints. Chibble, you stink. You are horrible. You can't even get through a ring announcement.
Damas y caballeros, gente escalada, todo el mundo. Aquí les presento al hombre al que la robaron del estilo de WrestleMania. A la esencia de excelencia.
SmackDown. Look at him. He's dressed nice. He's wearing a tuxedo. He's in shape. He doesn't look like a blob in a big orange shirt in a silly suit like Chibble does.
What are you talking about, Cody? You speak Spanish. You don't even know what he's saying.
Olé. Adios, Booker. That means go away for good.
Can't wait, man. I can't wait.
I have completely lost control of this broadcast. Del Rio goes one-on-one with Christian next.
We are back on Friday Night SmackDown. We're all set to find out who will go on to Extreme Rules to challenge Edge for the World Heavyweight Championship.
About this for a second, and what is at stake in this matchup? The winner will face Edge, but will face Edge in a ladder match for the World Championship. For Alberto Del Rio, he'd be entering new territory against a match that Edge made famous. For Christian, if he wins this match and faces Edge, that may be an even playing field. Both Christian and Edge are awesome. They invented the ladder match. Can you imagine that matchup?
Booker, who deserves this opportunity more, Alberto Del Rio or Captain Charisma Christian?
I can answer that, the winner.
Booker.
Like I say, it really doesn't matter because any way you look at it, Edge will be in his comfort zone come that ladder match, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, but so would Christian.
You think you know me?
Well, this isn't fair. This isn't right.
You don't even know what Edge is doing out here.
Well, it's probably no good. How can Alberto concentrate? The man's already destroyed his $120,000 automobile. He embarrassed the man. He ripped his personal property out of his hand.
Edge has every right to be out here. As long as Brodus plays out here, as long as Ricardo Rodriguez is out here, Edge is welcome Edge. Here to SmackDown.
How you doing, Edge? Good to see you, champ. Have a seat.
Edge, how you doing? Over here in the coal mine. How you doing, champ?
Cole, you're built like a bag of golf balls. You should shut up.
Edge, thank you very much for joining us here for this very important number one contenders match for your World Heavyweight Championship. One of these men will join you in a match you made famous, a ladder match, in 4 weeks at our next pay-per-view event, Extreme Rules.
Yeah, you know, looking at it on paper, maybe I should prefer to face Alberto Del Rio because Christian is also fairly masterful at the ladder match himself.
So you're scared of Christian is what you're saying?
I'm scared of you taking your shirt off again.
Well, why are you going to make it about me? Don't avoid the question, Edge. Answer the question. Are you scared of Christian?
Actually, if I've been in 19 ladder matches. Do I need to be afraid of anyone? No.
And Edge, earlier you did tell Christian, as Alberto Del Rio goes for the cover, that you hope Christian wins, that you hope to meet Christian in a ladder match for your world title.
I do. I mean, we've been best friends for 27 years. So, yeah, would I like to compete against him, give him a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship? I think he deserves it, yes. And honestly, I don't like Alberto Del Rio.
Edge, some people would argue, though, that Del Rio deserves the opportunity at your title more than Christian.
I don't agree. I beat Del Rio at WrestleMania. That was his chance. That was his shot. If he earns it, fine. I respect him as a competitor. Don't take that away from him.
Yeah, but you don't respect the man as a person. Anybody that would destroy a man's personal property, $120,000 Rolls Royce, and do it the way you did, Edge, does not respect the man personally.
I don't, because I don't think he respects anyone.
But what gives you the right to destroy his property? You should have been arrested.
Well, I tell you what, Cole, why don't you try and arrest me? Make a citizen's arrest. Give it a shot.
No, I have no desire to do that.
That's great.
Pace is quickening here. Christian taking down Alberto Del Rio. Quick cover here.
Almost got him. Edge, let me congratulate you on your big victory at WrestleMania. It was huge.
Thank you, Booker, man. I appreciate it.
You look good out there, kid.
Trying. You know, it was 10 years ago that you and I went at it.
10 years, man. You got to be kidding me, right?
Oh, the way we were. The love fest continues.
You know, Edge, I know this was a personal WrestleMania for you this past Sunday as you were looking to retain the World Heavyweight Championship, something that's, it's eluded you over the past few years at WrestleMania.
It's true. You know, I like to cling to the fact that I was in the World Heavyweight Championship matches at those WrestleManias, but yeah, I didn't walk out successful. So this year I wanted to.
Ooh. Big right hands by Christian.
Those are like rubber mallets. Trust me, I speak from experience.
And now Christian.
He scouted him. Alberto knows what he's doing. And these.